we almost full throttle here, 100% torque, and it's dropping. Okay, here I'm full throttle, around 26,000 feet, where it's maximum throttle up and around 100% torque. And I will continue our climb. Still, we can maintain with four people. Here we have three passengers and five people and two pilots that are counted automatically on the weight. Still, we can climb at 28,000 feet with 2,500 feet per minute. Pressurization going fine. As we see here, differential pressure have gone up to 6 atmospheres. Is this atmosphere? PSI? What is it? Don't remember. PSI. And still climbing. We have the turbine temperature that is on the limit. About 830 degrees is the limit. So we can go a bit lower here to be on the green area, or the green indication. Already have reached almost our cruising altitude. Other stuff we can do here, we can change here the page, see some values about the currents, etc. Also flaps, and from this button here you can display a checklist, change pages from here, and from these two bottom buttons we can change the item. Also here we have something like a flight plan, like a progress page from FMC, giving us some distances, times, time to go, estimated time of arrival, what fuel will we have when we reach there, the gross weight. Of course, these numbers are not exactly say, because they're computing on the based on the current speed. The correct thing is these numbers to be computed based on some profile, which I haven't done yet. This is something that I would like to do sometime in the future. As we see here, the aircraft starts to accelerate. We're above Mach 0.662, and we leave it to accelerate about Mach 0.65. As you see here, we have a ground speed of 360-70 knots. With 29 notch of right crosswind. Had a tablet and view the snowy Rockies. Let's go back. Okay, we must go a little bit back. Here it's about 0.65 Mach. Thank you, Cuckoo Bear. Άντε ρε, από πού? Ακαρδίτσα, εντάξει. Εγώ τρίκαλα. Μέσο χώρα. Okay. Βάλουμε λίγο ταχύτητα. Okay. See you later. Seventy-three miles from top of descent. About 10 minutes, maybe. the tablet. Let's start them up a bit. Approach course 265, minimum 5300 barometric at Rotka. Minimum for the approach is 3000 to 40. Now you can set the minimums going here to refs, and we turn the back knob here to the bar minimums. Okay, it will take some time. It's 3240. Uh-oh. 3240 minimums reference speed. This speed here, VT, is a target speed we can set as we like. For example, we'll set this to 220. Come on. As target speed for the descent, it's a user speed, something that we can set here. We see 220. Okay. V50 is the equivalent of V2 for the airliners, and VR is VR. And of course, V reference is the approach speed with full flaps. V50, VR, and VREF, you don't need to change. The changes between an empty aircraft and a full load aircraft is very small, maybe 1-2 knots, more or less. So, well, good enough. Also, we can set here with the barometric pressure to be in inches or hectopascals. Turn on the metric altitude, as you see here. Flight level alert is not set, it's not working, and of course we can change the flight director type from the cross here to V-bar, as you like. Miles. From the descent. One thing you should never do here in this aircraft is to press VNAV to go for VNAV mode. This is because an explain, unfortunately, the Vinav mode is connected with the autothrottle, and you cannot use Vinav without autothrottle. Even the aircraft has no autothrottle. If you press Vinav, the aircraft would try to achieve those things here. For example, those climb speeds, those cruise speeds, and etc., without expecting without taking care of not go above the limits for the engine, etc. So don't use it, don't use it. But you can use it. You can use it only before the coffee. You come here and set, for example, target speed, it's 250. I will go to 30, to 40. No. Clear. To 40, 10,000 feet. New restriction. And above here, we'll go to 40 again. And 0.6 for the Mach speed. Here, go to 40 or 0.655, not 8. And for the descent, we can go again. 0.6, does not work with this. No. Okay, set as limit to 40. Okay, that means a forward slash. No, I don't know. Anyway, don't use it. Okay, so we are approaching now we're 15 miles from the top of descent. Must be visible here. This dot. So we have an altitude restriction, 5,300 feet, and we'll set it here for the approach. Here in Manjeda, will show us what is the computed altitude for the next waypoint, as you see here, as well as there are any restrictions. Six thousand 500. No, 5,000. Okay. Anyway, will give us here the target altitude of the restrictions and the altitude restrictions, and we are five. So start descending now. I use vertical speed here. down. We'll start about to 2,500 feet, and I will reduce the power levels to idle, almost to idle. Went up to 3,000, down to 3,000 feet. For a reason, as we have pulled back the power levels, we can notice here that the oil temperature goes down. So we need an initial fast descent because we have to go slowly instead from a point onwards. Here, we don't want to go below 20 degrees temperature. So to keep the engines not to get frozen, we must add some power. Now I will decrease the vertical speed. Try to maintain an airspeed around to 20 to 30 knots. And not allow the oil to go below 20. So we add power and we reduce the rate of descent so we don't accelerate too much. 26, 27, we're good here, somewhere here. The power here is nice to keep the oil from not freezing. So, let's turn this to legs and increase the range. We hit 5,000 feet around here, so can go a bit slower on the descent. Fly by. Still going fast and turning now. Nice. reduce the set a bit to bleed some speed. So slowly down. Let's go. Barometric here is 29.77. Set below 18,000 feet. All flight level 180. I can deflect level change now. Why not? Let's set it to 220 and let the aircraft decelerate. Now we can use throttle to adjust the rate of descent. Here is Urnip, and we must be at about 5,300. That's two. Nice names. Okay, 2977 barometric. Okay, increase a bit and turn terrain radar on because we're approaching. The mountains here. Okay, we need to be at 40,000 feet and 26 miles, so we'll reduce about 500 feet per minute the descent. Reduce the range. Very nice place. Looks like a bit like the Alps. You can switch to the map here if you like. Salmon Arm. Kamloops, here is where we gonna land. Where you go? Okay, here. So the airport is around here. Yeah. The runway is this one here. Nice. About 10 minutes before landing. Let's do a check. Everything here looks good. Fuel flow, fuel quantity. We expect to have about 250 pounds of fuel and 9,000 pounds of gross weight on the landing, which is fine. Let's see, battery. Battery is cooled down, as you see. It's here. Temperature is about 132 says here, but it's below the limit, so it's okay. Of till the next waypoint, maybe to reduce throttle a bit to allow for a bit faster descent now. Must be around 40,000 feet there, you have 2,000 feet to lose. And about 1 minute to reach this point. Let's sorry. Let's see the weather here. Light showers, broken 5,300 feet, and overcast 9,000. So speed below 9,000 to be unbroken. You can see the ground. It's the next salt, next waypoint, Urnip, 22 miles, must be around 8,500 feet. let's accelerate a bit the descent. We'll increase our speed a bit because the temperature went below 20 degrees, and we need some power to keep it from going even below. Approaching Urnip. Seems there's some rain here. Here. Thousand to Rotka, altitude set. Let's go around here, probably. No. Make a left here to get aligned with the airport. Autopilot off, flight director off, we'll fly manual here the approach. We're a bit high, so we'll go a bit left-right to lose some speed. Now we have the terrain visual.
Caution terrain. Caution terrain.
Now we're low enough to go for the landing. Achieve maybe too much speed. So hold the left circle here to lose some speed.
Caution terrain. Caution terrain.
Okay, continue left turn. Flaps coming to mid. Landing light on. Flaps to max. And landing gear down. Okay, 15 knots headwind. Oh, auto feeder, right. Auto feeder on. Airspeed, try to maintain about 120. Seventeen is Vireth. A bit too high. Up here, the glide slope. Sink down. Reverse thrust. Don't need much. Reverse thrust off. Okay, here's the airport. Down the runway and to the right. Should be an exit here. Flaps coming up. Taxi lights on. this levers to flight idle. Turn the radar off. Here's for the big guys. Let's continue. Okay, somewhere here maybe. Okay. Message dropper two. Some on the windscreen. Oh. There's not much rain. So as the full effect. Go to feather. Pitot off. Leader off. Wait a couple of minutes for the engines to cool down. You can dump the pressure if you want here. Auto feeder off. Seat belt off. Anti collision ground off. The tablet. Just some drops. Only a few drops. I wish we had more rain. Okay, we can switch to more rain. I would delete manual, okay. Not heavy precipitation, just see the effect. Okay, here we got some rain going on now. Nicely brain effects for 1141 and expect soon to see in Vulcan. 2 minutes passed, so go cut off, fill cut off. If it goes down, firewall valves off, fuel pumps off, APU off, generators off, avionics off, and battery off. $2 to far away. And we can leave the aircraft. Oh no, it's any. Let's go back in. Let's go back in. So thanks for watching. This video will be uploaded to YouTube for anyone who wants to see it. See you another time, guys. Bye bye.